Welcome back to Our Community. Susie Thomas visiting with Michelle Beyer and Terry Hunka, talking about a family Christmas Eve. Share the warmth, taking place at the Martin Center. We need cooks. That's what we need. Now, let's point out, this is Christmas Eve, and Christmas Eve lands on a Sunday this year. So what does that do with the times and when you want people to bring things?
Well, How am I saying this? How am I going to say this? We prefer if you can bring it to us around 11 o'clock, but if there's something that you have to go to early, I will be there or someone will be there at 9. You know, if you come any earlier, we're not going to have the doors open, but we have to respect the Martin Center. They have a church service prior to. So we do not want to disrupt that and have everybody coming in and out too early. So,
and let me just point out that if you're bringing food, please come to door number 2.
Okay.
Okay, because otherwise you'll be going to church, whether you mean to or not.
What was that game show? Do you want door number 1?
Yeah.
Door number two.
So come to door number 2. It'll be, and you'll be able to come in right by the kitchen there, and Michelle will be right there. So
perfect. All right. And you want it to arrive prepared.
Definitely.
So that all you need to do is keep it warm or warm it up or whatever. Now, if it's something that they had to make a day early and it's coming cold, that's okay, right? Because we do have a fabulous kitchen provided by the Junior League of Stark County, thanks to a grant from
Walmart,
yes, because it is just a fabulous kitchen. So we'll be able to do some things, but please bring it ready.
Because if you think about it, that could turn into 100 people not being able to bring it, you know, warm, and then I'm trying to heat up. And that's a lot what happened last year.
Now, say somebody says, I'll bring a turkey. How would you like the turkey to arrive? On a platter, all beautiful and everything garnished, or?
No, please make sure everything is in a disposable pan. The tin pans you can buy for $1. And actually, when we give them out, we'll probably have tins. I believe that's what we did last year.
And carve them.
Last year,
yes.
It was, you know, I don't like to complain because we had someone cooking all 40 turkeys.
Yeah, that's awesome.
But the majority of them weren't cut. So I borrowed electric knives from friends, and then we had 5 or 6 people just there slicing turkey. And that took them away from other areas that we may have needed some help in.
So carving 40 turkeys on the spot, on the location, that sounds like quite a something.
Well, think about it. If you're trying to feed 700 people in a 3-hour span, you have to have the food ready to go out to serve, you know. So if she's having to cook beans, take them out of a can, you know, mix up mashed potatoes or whatever. That takes away from the preparedness and the, I mean, I don't want to say we need to be professional, but we need to be organized.
Right.
And that takes away from her organization of the kitchen.
Right. That just sounds great. All right. So if you are a person who is cooking a turkey, please carve it as well and bring it to you in a great big, I'm thinking of those great big foil pans, all carved and shredded, and be awesome.
And you know what? Like I said, I'm going to go out and I'm going to buy those pans. And when we give the turkeys out, which we'll announce the place that we're going to give them out as soon as we know when we're going to get the turkeys. And we'll put it up on our Facebook page. We have Gary created a Facebook page yesterday, I believe.
What's that called?
Okay, what is the Facebook? Do you know?
I think it's A Family Christmas Eve. I'd have to look it up.
I think
on
you're
my
right.
Phone.
A Family Christmas Eve, I think, is right. And you can also go to the Facebook page is it. There's a website and a Facebook page?
Yes. And you can go to the website through the Facebook page.
Okay.
So, and what I'll do is I'll put things up there periodically. And that was another thing that I did put up yesterday. We decided that we love that you volunteer, but we need to eliminate you bringing children this year. Anyone under the age of 18. Last year, we had people bringing their children, and I understand that, and I think that's wonderful that you want to teach your child, you know, to give up their, you know, do this for others. But it became very chaotic, and some were bringing, you know, infants, and that was just strollers running through when we have 700 people. You know, it just wasn't working. And, you know, we're not being mean or we have two grandchildren that we are raising, and they're 11 and 13, and we can't bring them. You know, well, we can't.
Another way to involve them, I would think, would be let them help in the in your own kitchen at home preparing the food, and you can instill that in them that way. That we're making this dinner, and we're going to share it with people, and then you can just run it on down, drop it off,
or have mm-hmm. them clean out their closets. You know, and say, hey,
exactly.
let's go donate
mm-hmm.
these. Mm-hmm. You know, to mm-hmm. the Anchor House or the Martin Center.
That
or
coat
whatever.
That doesn't fit you anymore.
You know, you can involve toys. Them in other ways. We're just not equipped. And Michelle's trying to be very political. I'm not as political.
I usually am not, so I'm shocked.
I think we all are.
Oh, okay.
But we're just not equipped to be babysitting service.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there's not enough jobs, volunteer opportunities for children.
Okay. Yeah. The times that this is taking place on December 24th at the Martin Center, what times are you going to be serving people?
We'll serve people starting at 2 o'clock, and we'll serve until 5, or until there's somebody at the door. Mm-hmm. I mean, let's just be
right.
honest here.
Yeah.
But we're asking you to respect our 2 o'clock time, because as Michelle said, Third Street Community Church does meet there, and they meet there until about 1 by the time they clean up their stuff. We get their stuff put away, then, and we have to set up, so... By the time we get all that done, please respect our 2 o'clock start time.
Yeah, that's going to be quite something to see. That'll be quite an operation to see
yeah.
one shut down and the other set up.
Yeah.
So again, bring food to door number 2. We're back to Let's Make a Deal. Door
number two.
Which is the door that I would think most people would go to mm-hmm. anyway?
I would too, because the other one is the gym door, and it says gym door.
I don't even know where it is. I mean, I'm always coming.
Go to the parking lot. The door at the parking lot, yeah. that's the one you want.
Yeah.
Yes, perfect. All right. So again... The location, some people may not know where the Martin Center is. So, Terry, okay. where are you located?
All Take right. it away, Terry.
We are located in downtown Canton. The address is 1253 3rd Street Southeast. So we're in the southeast quadrant. We are in the old Martin Elementary School, if any of you know where that is. We're just down the road towards downtown from Hartford Middle School. So if you know where either one of those schools are, that should give you a pretty good idea of where we're at.
For people who are not familiar with the Martin Center yet, you do a number of things there. Talk about that ministry, because it's pretty remarkable.
You know, we just open the doors and whatever happens,
yeah,
happens.
Really, no. I think it's a little more involved than
you
that.
Know. We have several nights throughout the week where we have kids come in. We let them play basketball. We have a little bit of an arcade, so we let them play the arcade games and stuff. But one of the things that we found out in ministering to our kids is they're hungry.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
and so we have made a pact, I guess, or something among all of us that we won't have an event without having food.
Mm-hmm. And that was something we were able to do last year, is we had so much food left over mm-hmm. that I was able to put trays of turkey and rolls and all this great stuff so they can feed those kids. And these are at-risk kids, aren't they?
They are. Mm-hmm. They are. You know, I mean, I can tell you some pretty sad stories, as you well know, and you do too.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to go into that. They are at-risk kids. And, you know, the cool thing is about having turkey left over is we have different crowd. We have middle school night coming one night. We have high school kids coming one night. We have older kids coming one night, and we have league night. So there's 4 different nights that we can serve turkey,
right?
And the same kids don't get it.
Right.
And
know,
isn't that the best part of Thanksgiving,
yes.
is eating the leftovers all the rest of the week? I know.
Yes.
We love to pick on the
yes.
turkey, and
yeah.
so will everybody at the Martin Center.
So we just try to minister to the kids. We are a faith-based operation, but you'd never know it as far as, like, we don't have Bibles sitting all over the place, and we don't say you have to, you know, learn 3 verses before you can come in and play basketball or something like that. We try to be Jesus mm-hmm. to the kids that come to the Martin Center.
And by doing that, you've seen some amazing lives changed. Can you tell us one story? Because I know you had a million of them.
I can tell you a story of a guy who has several children, and he... was a gang member and a very well-known drug dealer in Canton. fought us the whole way, you know. Oh, I don't need any of that religion stuff, you know, and everything. And I got mad at Corey one night. We were having a volunteer
picnic,
yeah. And he didn't come when he was supposed to. He was supposed to speak. And I'm like, you know, tap dancing or something, you know, which is funny in itself. And finally, when he came out, he said the reason that I was, and this is the Reader's Digest version, but the reason I was delayed is because I was talking to this young man and he accepted Christ.
How about
now,
that?
Now, how do you go from a well-known
yeah,
but I mean, he's got a lot of money, you know,
oh, yes,
and everything.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, supporting all these kids and baby mamas and,
yes,
and then going to a, you know, well, you're a Christian now, so you
job.
Don't have to do that. So go get a job and make
right.
$100,000 so you can support your family.
Yeah, and that's the difficult thing with mm-hmm. all, you know, people in recovery and
all
of that.
Absolutely, same
yes.
thing,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
Yeah.
How do they recover?
And that's one of the things I need to, I fight with, you know, and fight for, mm-hmm. you know, because if we can't get them jobs, we can't get
right.
them housing, we just put them back on the street.
Right.
That's what we do.
Right.
Yeah.
You know? The end of the story is he did get a job. He
awesome.
Got two, actually,
awesome.
So that he could get his enough money. He attends church every week. And he loves Jesus.
Wow.
Nice.
Wow. So, yeah.
Wow.
Is that...
That's amazing.
That's why you're doing
just,
what you do.
That's just one of the stories.
The Martin Center houses different organizations. Who all is located under your roof now?
Under our roof is Child and Adolescent Services. I probably shouldn't say the Refuge because they're kind of incognito.
Well, you just did.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah,
did. We'll keep it just among us
okay,
then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just the three of us.
Yes.
Yeah. We won't tell anybody else.
But they're in a capital campaign,
mm-hmm.
and so they needed
a
place to work
That's
and
right.
where they're not bothered with. Not bothered, but they're not, they don't have the interruptions of day-to-day activities.
Mm-hmm. It is a wonderful partnership, seeing the Martin Center and a family Christmas Eve share the warmth. And real easy, just if you're Googling it, if you want to make sure you're finding the right website and the right Facebook page, if you go to Family Christmas Eve, if you see the logo that says Share the Warmth on it, it's the only Family Christmas Eve that's got the Share the Warmth.
So
you'll
people.
Know you're at the right place.
Yeah.
So that is how to donate food. Any other ways? We need everybody to get in touch and say, I'll make this and I'll make that.
I prefer everyone to go through the website.
That
it
sounds
will make
perfect.
Things easier. I know I still have people saying, hey, I'll do it, you know, and they're not going to the Facebook page and, I mean, I'm sorry, the website, and that's because it's not ready. We will have that ready at some point this week.
Okay.
But there is one thing I need to say. You had a listener last year that heard us, me and Bud, and she donated Bibles to us.
Aww.
And all I needed to do was pick them up. I could not get there to pick them up. And I apologize to whomever that was that got us Bibles last year. It's not that we didn't want them. I ran out of time. I couldn't pick them up. And I felt so bad because here she was giving us these Bibles. And I couldn't even return her call. It was just crazy. So I'm hoping that you're listening.
Maybe this is the year that's going to happen. So if that happened to be you, you can call the station here, 330-492-9590. We'll make sure something happens here.
Yeah.
It's a family Christmas Eve. Share the warmth. Michelle Byer, Terry Hunka, thank you so much for all you do in our community.
Thank you, Susie.
Thank you.